Greetings, everyone. 2K Sports brings you the NBA. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg. A quick check now at the starting five for both teams. First for the Hawks, Dennis Schroeder is out there with Kyle Korver. And at center, the most dominant physical presence in the NBA, the elite defensive big man, Dwight Howard. And there's money. And it's Millsap in at the four. And for Boston, Isaiah Thomas out there with Avery Bradley. And holding down the middle, a tremendously hard-working and versatile big man out of the Dominican Republic, Al Horford. Then there's Brown, and it's Sellinger in at the four-man position. Certainly the biggest surprise last year, Clark, was the play of the Atlanta Hawks. You would have picked them to win the East at the start of the season.
Well, they did it, and they earned it. The Hawks didn't have any superstars on their roster, but they won with solid team play.
And so off the tip, it's Boston. And here is Thomas. It's Brown on the wing. Back to Thomas. Beyond the arc. Dwight Howard pulls it in.
And for the Hawks, they did end up with four All-Stars last season. As you said, it was all about how they worked together as a team.
It's good on the putback.
Excellent work to turn that miss into 2 points on the tap in.
Hustle points, I believe they called it.
Yeah, and how great are his ball instincts there? Just having a knack, really the instincts to just get after it on the backboard.
Now, here's Thomas. Horford kicks to Thomas. Good on the 3-point shot.
And you know, around the NBA, the league recognized the Hawks were a complete team. Everybody played their role superbly. The NBA named all five of their starters the player of the week last year in an unprecedented move.
And here's Korver after Isaiah Thomas made that last 3-pointer.
Back at you. I mean, they immediately get those 3 points back.
Trading spray guns from long range, trading blows from behind the arc.
Bradley. At the lead pass, Horford. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
Let's send it over to Doris Burke, who caught up with head coach Mike Budenholzer. Doris?
He talked about the impact that Al Horford can have on a game and how they'll have their work cut out for them dealing with him. He said Horford's just a complete ball player. He does all the things you want from a big man. He can shoot, handle, and pass. He's always a tough matchup, but it starts with matching his energy level. Kevin, we'll see if they have what it takes.
Thanks, Doris. And Bradley gets it to go on the assist by Brown. Bradley's got himself on the board with three there. Here's Schroeder. Pulls up a screen. Kicks it out to Prince. That three off the mark. Boston's gone two or three from deep so far in this game. Thomas, guarded by Korver. Bradley passes to Thomas. It's Brown on the wing. Guarded by Prince. Releases from 15, and it's Boston with another.
You know, you're going to have success when you can start out shooting 80% from the game. So early offensively, they've been great. That's the way you like to shoot.
Now, here's Howard. Pass to Schroeder. Six on the shot clock. And Millsap, here we go. Good D by Sellinger.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that.
And really a fantastic season for Sellinger last year. Really made some leaps forward, but missed a lot of time still due to injury.
Schroeder kicks to Millsap. Prince outside. It's good from long range. Prince has got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played. Picked by Horford. Outside Thomas. Passes it to Brandon. They get a hand on it. It's stolen by Korver. Puts the lead pass in front of him. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Not trying to rattle any rims or racks there. Just up and in with the finger roll.
And Kyle Korver enjoying a career renaissance, if you will, here in his 30s. A former late second-round pick. He's kicked around the league a little bit. He's really found his niche here in the motion offense of the Atlanta Hawks.
A little background on Kyle Korver. Drafted 51st by the Nets back in 2003. They sold his rights to the Sixers for a little over $100,000 and used the proceeds to pay for their summer league fee.
Well, that, and they also bought a new color copier for whatever that information is worth. It might sound like a mistake in hindsight, but I heard that machine is very reliable.
Here's Schroeder after Jared Sullinger's bucket. Power dishes to Schroeder. He feeds it to Prince for the three. Rebounded by the Celtics. Thomas with the ball. This one for three. And again, Boston with the triple.
And another lead change here. How many of these are we going to have tonight?
I'm not quite sure, but I'm willing to bet it'll be more than a few.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game. The Hawks trail it. Here's Schroeder. Dishes it to Howard. Working on Horford. A jump hook. And Howard with the nice bucket inside. Howard's got his second bucket. The Celtics have gone 6 of 8 in the game so far. A very solid start for them. Sullinger with a screen for Thomas. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
And has gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Prince, the pass to Millsap. And he gets it to go.
Not much defense to speak of yet here, guys.
Nope. It's been all offense, fellas, all the time here early.
Now, here's Bradley. There's the dish to Thomas. Offline with his three. Hawks have gone 7 of 11 from the field to begin the game. Millsap a screen on Sullinger. Korver kicks to Millsap. The shot is off. Good D by Sullinger. Boston's gone 3 of 5 from three-point land so far in the ballgame. Bradley dishes to Horford. And the shot is good.
You know, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
It's like a running game in football. When you can pound the basketball inside, it also allows you to control the team's transition.
Here's Korver for three. Jared Sullinger pulls it in. Sullinger's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Bradley kicks to Thomas. Back to Bradley. Let's the three fly. No luck.
Really good rebound in traffic. That's what the big fella's there for.
Well, last year for the Celtics, they weren't exactly world beaters at home. Still good enough, though, to get the job done.
Yeah, just a game over 500 here in Boston. Not great, but at least it was over 500 for a young up-and-coming team.
Now Thomas, after Kyle Korver missing on that last three-pointer. Bradley kicks to Thomas. Kick out to Brown. Bradley. Nice ball movement by Boston. Thomas passes to Horford. Back to Thomas. It's Bradley on the wing. Brown outside. Lock at 6. Eyes again. He lays it in.
I'm not sure who was supposed to be on him that possession. I mean, apparently, neither did the defender.
The Hawks trail by 4. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
I got to find something, you're right. Time called here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. Last season, Atlanta showed just how much fun a team can have playing team basketball, a complete team effort. We use that word a lot. You don't see it much in the NBA, but boy, they epitomized the club.
Yeah, they sure did. Refreshing to see a team do that well collectively without a real superstar. Just a solid group that understood their roles and played them perfect.
And the Hawks with a completely new group on the floor. Here's Mack. Back to Scott. B frames the three-pointer. B's got his first 3 points of the game.
He might not have the long-range ability of some other guys, but he will knock down open ones like that. And, folks, it's not like the Hawks didn't have talent. I mean, they did have four All-Stars last year. None of them voted in, however.
There's the bucket. Good.
And didn't have to go strong there. Just a little bit of the finger roll to get it up over the deep.
The Hawks trail by three. Here's Mack. Splitter sets a screen. Mack dishes to Splitter. Banked in off the glass.
You know, what shows you just how team-oriented the Hawks were last season was this stat. They never had anybody score more than 30 points for them in a game all season. Millsap had 30 points once early in the year, and that was the high mark for the team.
Here's Smart after the basket by Atlanta. Shot clock at six. From deep three-point range, rebounded by the Hawks.
Not good shot selection, long range, and a defender all up in your jersey.
And, you know, that's just the kind of defensive work he's known for. I mean, he can take that shot away from you and does it more times than not.
Count that one. Clark, a lot of give and take between these sides early.
Kevin, how about six lead changes in this half already?
Yeah, and both teams look like they came to play. We should have a good one.
Got it up. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And there's the horn. We've seen some good defense on both sides, and the score is still close. Hawks lead by one. And the second quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And what do you guys think about the Hawks here in this one?
It's been about the pace. You can see they're going to try to keep this game in the open floor.
Yeah, and, you know, it's been a tempo that they like, and they're getting some easy buckets in transition here.
And Mack kicks to Cephalosha. Mack shoots. Zeller grabs the board.
The defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
Smart passes to Rozier. A three-pointer, no good. Atlanta's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Mack dishes to Scott. And there's the pass to Mack. Now Cephalosha. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Mack shoots it up. Off the left rim and out. Boston trailing. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Rozier, the pass to Smart. Here's Rozier from deep. And Splitter pulls it down.
Well, so far for Coach Brad Stevens, the Celtics have had nothing but praise for their outstanding young coach. No surprise for those of us who know Brad. The team is really moving ahead in the rebuilding process, and he gets a lot of the credit for it.
From deep, from beyond the arc, and then some. And it's 6 points for B. Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. And part of the reason why the Celtics are ahead of schedule in the rebuild is because of Coach Brad Stevens. He has everyone on the same page.
You know what? You talk around the league about Coach Stevens, and other coaches are just astounded by his work ethic. People around the league think he's already a top coach and could be one of the greats by the time he's done if he stays at the professional level.
For the Hawks, Mike Muscala comes in for Splitter. And it's Kent Bazemore in for B. Two minutes now played in the second quarter. Here's Davis. A terrific shot on the turnaround.
know, you can give a defender a lot of trouble if you're consistent with that turnaround jumper. It's almost impossible to block.
Pass to Scott. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. Scott's got his first bucket in this one. Here's Turner. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Feeds to Smart. Shoots the three. And the shot is good.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all alone for that shot. It was a warm-up jumper.
They set the pick. And Bazemore kicks to Scott. The Hawks working the ball around. And there's the feed to Matt. He dishes it to Bazemore. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. The Celtics have gone 2-for-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Now here's Turner. To the paint. Olynyk. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
And the thing with Kelly Olynyk, he does some stuff that really helps you. And some also that will hurt. I mean, he's highly skilled. He's got the deep range, textbook positioning in terms of the post. A lot of tricky moves down there. Yet he has a hard time being effective against great athletes, which the NBA is filled with. So he's going to have to evolve as a basketball player if he wants to be effective.
Well, and back to Kelly Olynyk. As a coach, you have to identify the matchups where he can be effective, because Clark is against explosive long limb guys. They'll take advantage of him.
Yeah, they will. But in the right matchup, he's effective. He can help you. Makes 35% of his threes. Has done that for the last 2 years. And I think he gives you some toughness and rebounding as well. I like him as a second unit player.
Mack dishes to Bazemore. He kicks it to Mack. Out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. And the Hawks making a change here. Millsaps checked in. The Celtics with the lead. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. From downtown, and he gets the bucket.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they need.
Outside Turner. Kicks to Smart. Back to Turner. No luck. Good work defensively by Millsap. The Hawks trail by 4. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Out of bounds, Boston takes possession. Dennis Schroeder's checked in for Atlanta. And here's Smart. Pass to Thomas. 6 to shoot. Austin needs to get off a shot. Shoots it. And he knocks down the jumper. Thomas got 10 points in the game. The Hawks trail by 6. Atlanta calls timeout. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Jared Sullinger's check in for Davis. And it's Avery Bradley in for Marcus Smart.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Nicely done.
Celtics leading by 4. The Boston Celtics figured to be near the bottom of the league last year. In many ways, they outperformed a lot of people's expectations.
And by no means were they a contender at any point, but they very well could be ahead of themselves in terms of the rebuilding process.
Here's Schroeder. Millsap a screen on Thomas. Schroeder with the ball. He passes to Bazeman. Great D on that shot, and it's off the mark. And it's the Celtics ball. They're on a 15-4 run right now. Bradley kicks to Crowder. Offensive rebound, and he gets it to go.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
And Bazemore kicks it over to Schroeder. Passes it to Bazemore. That one's good from the corner. Boston leading by 7. Bradley kicks to Thomas. Sullinger passes to Thomas. Shot clock at 6. Rebound by Muscala. The Hawks trail by 7. Bazemore dishes to Cephalosha. Bazemore, that's good. Bazemore's got his second basket.
Really good example there of some fine interior passing before that pass.
Bradley kicks to Thomas. He feeds it to Sullinger. Dishes it to Olynyk. The jump hook. The shot is good off the backboard. Olynyk's got 6.
Yeah, sloppy D there. You can't let him get the ball in his hands down there.
Extremely untidy on the defensive end. I mean, when he gets it in that close, that's an easy bucket.
And Bazemore kicks it over to Schroeder. Millsap a screen on Thomas. Another shot. Good. 6 points for him.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Now the dish to Crowder. Ah! Oh, good with the triple. The Hawks trail by 5. And Muscala kicks to Millsap. The pass to Bazemore. Traps in the tray. Bazemore's got 9 points.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
Outside Thomas. Olynyk up top. Crowder fires for 3. Goes back up. Rejected by Millsap. Here's Schroeder. That doesn't go on the chance to tie.
Usually if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there.
Here's Crowder. That's in there. Thomas with the assist. Crowder's got 9 points in the quarter.
And that's what you like to see from a competitor. Really able to just shake off that poor first quarter and focus on the here and now.
And Bazemore kicks to Millsap. Pass to Bazemore. Feeds to Millsap. Right side Millsap. 8 feet away. That's good. Millsap's got 6.
And Kevin, they started the game shooting it so well. I'm surprised they haven't continued. They've got to get back to their strength.
Yeah, I mean, test the hot hand. You're exactly right. I say let those triples fly.
Thomas passes to Brandon. No good from outside. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Celtics out in front, leading by 3. It's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now.
Looking at the game for Thomas, he's got 10 points, and he's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
I love the rhythm his outside stroke has produced today.
And Howard with the stuff.
And gobbled up that rebound and went straight into attack mode on the putback.
He is one of the most determined rebounders, Clark, we have got in the NBA.
Yeah, you're calling it right, Kevin. I mean, he gets so many second chance points because of how hard he works to get to the rebound.
And finished off by Sullinger.
And you know what? He is also relentless on the board. He works as hard on his rebounding as anybody you're going to see.
Kicks to Prince. Millsap sets the pick for Prince. It's hauled in by Brown. Boston leading by three. And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. And it's Bradley off the drive. The three from Thomas. Dwight Howard pulls it in. Howard's got his fourth rebound in this one.
And Isaiah Thomas traded last season from Phoenix over to Boston. Seemed to be a matter of fit and not production as to why they moved him. That's one for their first four to start the second half.
Bradley against Millsap. Thomas kicks to Brown. Good, and the assist goes to Thomas. And now a six-point Boston lead. You were talking about Isaiah Thomas. He had no love lost for the Suns in their first meeting. He took them apart, Clark, on the floor. Remember that game? Stared them down as he was hitting shots, looked at that bench, and then he had a big chip on his shoulder.
Yeah, and you know, most guys that are a little undersized and have battled doubters all their careers bring that kind of edge anyway. You throw in the fact that he was disappointed how the trade unfolded. He was amped up and ready for that return visit.
Prince dishes to Howard, and that one's good. Howard's got eight.
He got a little room at the rim and laid it in. Great play.
Boston leading by four. Sullinger a screen on Korver. Millsap with a double team. Bradley kicks to Sullinger. Outside Thomas. There's the feed to Bradley. Horford sets a screen for Brent. Back to Thomas. That doesn't go either for Thomas.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Kicks it out to Prince. Guarded by Bradley. 17-foot shot on the way. Good on the shot. And now, just a 2-point Celtic lead. Boston's gone 1-of-4 in 3-point shots here in the third. He dishes it to Thomas. Back to Bradley. The Celtics working the ball around now. That's good from Thomas on the assist by Bradley. And that's 13 points for Isaiah Thomas.
There's 6 points on consecutive free ball. They're finding holes in this defense.
No doubt the defense had better play a little tighter.
Atlanta calls timeout. It was a tough battle down the stretch, but the Celtics were able to get back into the playoffs last year.
And kind of just hovering around all season, but give them credit. They fought their way in and spent only 1 year out of the postseason in their rebuild.
Davis has checked in for the Celtics. Schroeder with the ball. Now Thomas defending. Here's Korver for three. And Boston with the rebound. Horford's got three rebounds now in this one. Out of bounds, Boston takes possession.
That's a major mental mistake. I mean, there's no other way for me to describe it. He didn't know where he was on the court. That's a basic fundamental. You have to be alert to where you are.
Splitter is checked in for Atlanta. Bradley kicks to Thomas. And there's the call on Howard. That's his first foul. Horford the pass to Brown. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
the Hawks were fantastic last season. After the All-Star break, they did slip up a bit, struggled against teams over 500.
And the first one at the line is good. They lost the last three games of the regular season, Clark, and really just limped into the playoffs. Some of it might have just been fatigue.
Yeah, it could have been. And their play at the end of the season did leak into the playoffs, Kevin. I mean, you could see very quickly that they weren't the same team that looked so dominant during the regular season.
Both good from the line that time.
You know, not many saw it coming last season with the Hawks. I mean, they just ran away with the Eastern Conference. It was the first time they took the East since 1994.
Gets to Korver. Sinks the triple. Korver's got 6 points.
That's a layup for him. He's just too open.
Austin leading by four. Outside Brandon. Back to Thomas. He kicks it to Brown. Just five to shoot. 11 feet away. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. He's got 11. And with the Hawks and the E's, they just dominated the rest of the division. 39 of the Hawks' 60 regular season wins came in conference.
Yeah, and across the board, the Hawks statistically just dominated all Eastern opponents. They shot it better, played better defense, took better care of the ball. They are set up to be a factor in this conference for a long time.
Korver, no luck.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
Thomas goes in. It's blocked.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Here's Prince. Takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely.
Boy, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip. They've got a battle inside.
This game has been a battle, and maybe they're starting to just run out of gas a little bit.
Bradley kicks to Horford. Shoots from 14. That one a little long.
High quality shot. Just a little off there with the release.
And Greg, that has him S-H-H-E shaking his head. Tough miss that time.
It's Brown on the wing. A shot. Dwight Howard grabs the board. Howard's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Splitter with a screen on Horford. Korver dishes to Schroeder. Splitter sets a screen. Davis with the double team. Schroeder passes to Splitter. Prince. And again, it's Atlanta.
Well, nothing was going down for him in the first half, but since the break, he's been on target.
Boston's gone 2 of 5 with the 3-point shot since coming out of the break. Now a timeout called by Boston.
Well, you know, last season I thought the Celtics made some strong waves in the East. I mean, they kept fighting and fighting all season long, and they ended up in the playoffs because of that never-give-up attitude.
Atlanta making some changes. Mike Scott's checked in for Howard. He comes in for Money. And Shelvin Max subbed in for Dennis Schroeder. Here's Smart. Kicks it to Thomas. Pass to Smart. Back to Thomas. No one near him. Good, and Smart gets the assist. 15 points for Isaiah Thomas. The Hawks trail by 4. Here's Mack. Scott with a screen on Thomas. Passes to Mack. And Davis pulls it down.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Yeah, tit for tat on the glass. Just one more aspect of what's been a very closely contested ball game here.
And every once in a while, he'll show up and give you some great moves around the hoop.
Outside Korver. He passes to Matt. Leads him in there. Here's B. splitter, kicks to Korver. No one covering. Korver's got 5 points now in the quarter. And Boston has possession. Outside Thomas. He feeds it to Smart. Outside Turner. Atlanta with the rebound.
There's no getting around the simple fact that that's a shot he has to knock down.
And that one's good. Now just a 2-point Celtic lead.
Not much the defense can do once he gets to the bucket.
For Boston, they've gone 6 of 14 since halftime. A little cold from the field. 109 left to play in the third. Dishes it to Thomas. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here the step back. That's good. Thomas got 17.
Easy little jumper for him right there, guys.
The Hawks trail by 4. Here's Matt. Korver with it. Now guarded by Smart. And Matt gets to Korver. And the 3 off target. For Boston, they've gone 7 of 15 from the field here in the third quarter. Zeller setting the pick for Thomas. The dish to Smart. Fires the 3. The shot is off. And Atlanta will go the other way with it. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Outside for Korver. And Evan Turner pulls it down.
Most of the time, that shot will go down. Boy, the defenders have to make sure they tag.
Thomas goes in. Soft touch off the glass. And it's a 6-point Celtic lead.
That was just a perfect possession. Getting it in tight for the high percentage shot.
And we've reached the end of the third. Celtics lead by 6. All right, the fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. And a moment now to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Boston.
What a tremendous showing from the three-pointer all through this game.
Well, you've also got to love how aggressively they've taken that ball to the basket and scored off dribble penetration.
On the wing, Korver. The pass to Schroeder. Back to Korver. Pass to Schroeder. There's the 3. And Boston with the rebound. Davis has got 4 rebounds now tonight. Zeller, a screen on Millsap. And it's Turner off the drive. And that one's good.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
Kicks to Howard. It's good from in tight.
Consistency all game long. He's going to continue, I think, to have to take it over to get them back in the game.
Celtics leading by 6. That'll be Boston as it goes out of bounds. Celtics retain possession. Some changes for Boston. Al Horford, he's checked in for Tyler Zeller. Jared Sollinger comes in for Davis. And it's Avery Bradley in for Evan Turner. Horford dishes to Thomas. Kicks it out to Bradley. 6 on the shot clock. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. Paul Millsap picks one up. Taking a look at Avery Bradley, his career has been kind of up and down, Greg. Started out in high school where he developed into one of the nation's top prospects in high school.
You know, it's a great point. And as a college freshman, really established himself as one of the top defensive guards in the country. Won numerous awards, then enters the draft after only 1 year.
You know, with Avery Bradley, he was the 19th pick in the draft for the Celtics. The outlook for him was great, but then ball handling and shooting injury concerns flattened out his development. He had a hard time getting over the hump for a few years, but he's over it now.
And, you know, getting back to Avery Bradley, he's been dynamite the last 2 years. He's finally found consistency with the mid-range jumper and plays a complete game of basketball. With just a little more seasoning, I really feel like the sky's the limit.
And the deeper we get into this game, it seems like the more the offenses are in rhythm.
Without question, I mean, both of these teams are firing on full broadband bandwidth. I mean, full throttle.
Again, the miss by the Celtics.
And honestly, not real happy with the shot selection on that one.
Yeah, clearly a brain fade there. He's got to be a little smarter in his choice making.
B. Off target from three-point range.
Oh, no!
Outside Thomas. Feeds it to Bradley. Busted. No good that time either. The Hawks trail by five. Korver with it. Now Thomas defending. Howard with a screen on Horford. Schroeder passes to Howard. The feed to Schroeder. B. Nailed from three-point land. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. The Celtics have gone 1-4 since the end of the third quarter. Bradley kicks to Thomas. Back to Bradley. He dishes it to Crowder. Goes up and lays it nice and easy.
Great move to the hoop on that one there. He didn't let his height disadvantage dictate that matchup.
Atlanta's gotten off 4 three-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. He kicks to Korver. And it's off from three-point range. Celtics leading by 4. And Thomas. Sullinger with a screen for Thomas. A good look from Bradley. That's good. And it's Thomas picking up the assist. Thomas got 3 assists now in this one. Hawks have gone 3 of 6 in the field so far in the fourth quarter. Millsap a screen on Thomas. Sullinger brings the double team. Lock at 6. Korver attacking. Jared Sullinger grabs the board. Sullinger's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Upside Thomas. Now here's Crowder. Millsap covering. Now here's Crowder. Shot no good. Good work defensively by Millsap. Korver against Horford. Millsap kicks to Korver. Howard with a screen on Thomas. A 3-ball. And it's Schroeder missing.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there. And I'm sure he appreciated it.
Outside Brent. Right side Thomas. Let's it go from 14. That's good. Thomas got 11 in the second half. The Hawks trail by 8. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
That is good. And that's 13 points for B.
And, you know, he's enjoyed the kind of day you expect in terms of shooting the basketball. He can bring them right back into this game.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
And Dennis Schroeder has drawn some comparison to Rajon Rondo. Long arms, very quick and athletic. He's awfully tough to keep in front of you, but he's also a guy that can knock down a mid-range jump shot.
Brown is checked in for Jay Crowder. Kicks it to Thomas. Right side Thomas. Dwight Howard grabs the board. Howard's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Pass to Korver. He feeds it to Schroeder. Back to Korver. From the arc. And the shot is good. Now it's just a 3-point Celtic lead.
He's starting to heat up from outside. That's his second this half.
The Celtics have gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth. 4 of 9. Korver against Bradley. On the wing, Brown. Back to Bradley. Shot clock at 5. 3-pointer. And he gets it to go.
There is no way. No way a player like him can be left wide open like that. Did you pay attention to the scouting report?
Kicks to Korver. Korver missing again.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, it seemed like he had great rhythm on that. You can see the disappointment in his face. Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
Hawks making a switch here. Prince has checked in. Outside Bradley. Passes it to Thomas. Back to Bradley. And it's good. Bradley's got 9 points now in the quarter.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of it.
Peter passes to Korver. And Boston with the rebound. Zellinger's got rebound number 12 here already in the game.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Thomas kicks to Brown. Dishes to Horford. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. The Hawks trail by 8. Now the pass to Schroeder. Feeds it to Millsap. There's 1:47 left in the fourth. He passes to Prince. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
He's definitely turned things around in this game. I mean, he was more of a background player in the first half. He jumped center stage now.
For Prince. .132 left to play in the final quarter. It's tipped. Kicks to Prince. Softly drops in the floater. Now it's just a 3-point Celtic lead.
Boy, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They're in front by 3. 1:21 left here in the fourth quarter. Find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Hey, guys. Well, Brad Stevens had some advice for the team over that last break. He told them, the game is right there for the taking, fellas, but we've got to be first. First to lose balls, first to the rim. We have to give our all right here. Kevin, now's the time.
It is now to Howard. And as it goes out of bounds, Atlanta able to keep the ball here. Atlanta calls timeout. They're losing by 3. 1:05 left in the fourth quarter. .05 left in the fourth quarter. Korver kicks it over to Schroeder. He nails it, and we're tied up.
Boy, he quieted the crowd with that big shot. That's a big play.
Ouch. That was a punch in the gut to these fans.
Thomas kicks to Sullen. Shot clock at 6. Puts it up. Buries it.
As clutch a shot as I have ever seen.
In a word, gutsy.
Hawks shooting about 47% here in the fourth. Prince dishes to Schroeder. Back to Prince. Howard setting the pick for Prince. Pass to Korver. All sorts of time. Will not go. This is off the front iron. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
You got a foul. I mean, it's going to come down to free throws here. Foul right away.
And the first of two, no good. Heartbreaker. He's able to hit the second one, and that makes it a three-point lead. Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. They're behind by three. 16 seconds left in the game. To Prince, takes a three off target from downtown, and they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul. The first, and that gives them a four-point cushion. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a five-point game.
And that's curtains for him. Some really good work at the charity stripe to close this one out. You'll never see too many guys who can put forth an effort on the boards like this one, bro.
Yeah, as a former outstanding rebounder myself, I can certainly appreciate what this guy is doing. An extraordinary combination of talent and desire is what allows him to do what he's done today. Great performance.
And so it's the Boston Celtics with the W. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds clock.
You know what? They showed their character in crunch time, though, doing what had to be done to send these fans home happy.
And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, Clark Kellogg, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And as we leave, we give you our Jordan Player of the Game, Isaiah Thomas.